Now, the last we're talking about today is De Morgan's law, or De Morgan's law, which we always talk about when we come to sex. You know, the law states some operations based on sex. I'll just write them and have a little discussion about that. You propose that A complement union, B complement will be giving us A intersection B, all complements. Also, you said A complement intersection B complement gives us A union B, all complements. And you also give us A intersection B union C in a bracket. We can use a distributive property giving us A intersection B in round bracket all union A intersection C. How true are those laws? We must prove that they are true, because every law is something that is true in nature. So I would like to take one of the examples and I work it and show you how we prove it. Then the rest of the two will be an assignment for you to try your hands on. So starting with the first law. To prove, let's see the steps we need to take. One, you have to choose the side you want to prove from. Either you prove from the left to the right, or you prove from the right to the left. It's your own decision, but you must do for both, but you choose where you want to start from. And after we've chosen a side, for example, we are going to choose to start from the left to the right. So I'm proving that if an element belongs to A complement union B complement, it can also belong to the right hand side of the equation. So since I've chosen the side I'll start from, the next step is to state the conditions under which the side I've chosen will hold. We've done that earlier on. And also, after choosing the side, stating the conditions, we have to test the conditions and see how well they work, and that we can make our conclusion. So stating the conditions, when we say X belongs to A complement union B complement, what comes into mind? It means our X belongs to either A complement alone, or that element belongs to B complement alone, or may belong to what? Both of them. At the same time. But let's take one of the conditions and prove whether it's true or not. So I want to prove this condition that X belongs to A complement alone. So if X belongs to A complement alone, meaning at that particular time, X wouldn't belong to B complement, so it can be found only in A complement. What happens? It simply means that X does not belong to A, and X belongs to B. If you don't belong to B complement, you belong to B. If you belong to A complement, it means you don't belong to what? A. Now, if I'm not in A, but I'm in B, can I be part of their union? Yes. Union means it should be at one particular place at a time, if possible. Since it's not in this and it's that, it can be in what? Their complement. Because we have A complement here, and we don't have A B complement, but we can still have what? Their union. So I can testify that X can what? Belong to A union B complement at this time. So trying to compare this side with that, if I can belong to this one, can I also belong to this? Let's see and make a conclusion here. If I belong to A complement and I don't belong to B complement, and I have A intersection B complement, what comes to mind? If I don't belong to A and I belong to B, can I belong to A intersection B? No, I can't belong to A intersection B. If I don't belong to A intersection B, automatically I belong to what? Their complement. So we can confirm that any element that is here can also be found out here. Now let's try to do the opposite. When an element belongs here, can it be found here? Then we bring our lesson to an end. Now going from the other side, we are assuming X belongs to A intersection B complement. Now let's take the condition. The condition is that X does not belong to A intersection B. If you belong to their complement, then you don't belong to the actual set. If I don't belong to A intersection B, it may be that X does not belong to A, or X does not belong to B. We have two conditions here. It may be here, not there. It may not be here, it may be there. So we choose one of the conditions. And let's choose this one. If X does not belong to A, and at that time it belongs to B, what conclusion can I make? I can say that if X does not belong to A, then it will belong to what? A complement. And belongs to what? B at the same time. So when I belong to A complement and at the same time I belong to B, can I be in A complement union B complement? Yes. Since it's a union, you only need one side and it can be found in what? A complement. So I can conclude that X can belong to what? A complement union B complement. So therefore, the Murphy's law holds that A complement union B complement is the same as what? A complement intersection B complement. So I hope you go through these steps and be able to prove for the second and third block as your assignment. But before we bring this lesson to an end, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Okay, when you subscribe to the channel and you have many questions or any misunderstandings, you can send us an email and we will happily answer that question for you. Help you either by means of videos, or we can send you a direct PDF or Word form of the solution to your email. So don't forget to subscribe or like our videos as you are downloading them. Thank you. To meet again with another goodbye.